हाय स्टूडेंट्स, ये बात पहले भी हो चुकी है कि अगर आपका सिलेबस पूरा है तो एग्जाम से कुछ हफ्ते पहले पूरे सिलेबस को स्ट्रॉन्ग रिवाइज करना और क्वेश्चन पे अटैक करने का तरीका सीखने का बेस्ट तरीका होता है स्पीड सॉल्यूशंस को देखना। आप जेई मेन या नीट किसी भी एग्जाम की तैयारी कर रहे हैं, दोनों एग्जाम्स के स्पीड सॉल्यूशंस आपके ब्रेन को काफी स्टिमुलेटेड रखते हैं। आज इस वीडियो में मैं जेई मेन 22 के 24 जून की इवनिंग शिफ्ट के पेपर के स्पीड सॉल्यूशंस लूंगा और आप रियलाइज करेंगे कि क्वेश्चंस कितने फंडामेंटली हैंडल किए जा सकते हैं। इनके शॉर्ट नोट्स बनाते हुए चलें, कहीं पे भी कोई गैप आता है तो आप हमारी रिवीजन चेकलिस्ट देख सकते हैं, एनसीईआरटी को रेफर कर सकते हैं। पहले भी मैं बता चुका हूं कि इन जनरल अराउंड 60-65% क्वेश्चंस डायरेक्टली एनसीईआरटी लिंक होते हैं जेई मेन में। नीट में अराउंड 80-85% डायरेक्ट एनसीईआरटी से क्वेश्चंस पूछे जाते हैं और बाकी बहुत सारे डीपीवाईक्यूज रहते हैं। हमारे डीपीवाईक्यू पेपर्स को आप एक्सेस करना चाहते हैं तो टेलीग्राम चैनल को इमीडिएटली ज्वाइन करें, t.me/fazilgalaxyworld, जहां पे बहुत सारे एकेडमिक रिसोर्सेज और टेस्ट पेपर्स हैं जिनके सॉल्यूशन पीजी मोबाइल ऐप पे व्यू ओनली मोड के अंदर है। स्टे ट्यून्ड विद आवर इकोसिस्टम। लेट मी स्टार्ट विद द स्पीड सॉल्यूशन ऑफ 24th जून इवनिंग शिफ्ट। दिस गोइंग टू टर्न योर ब्रेन एट सच अ लेवल वेयर यू विल रियलाइज कि कितने इजीली आप दिमाग में सब कुछ रिटेन रख सकते हैं और एग्जाम में ऐसी ही स्पीड के ऊपर सारी चीजें आप हैंडल करेंगे। आइए स्टार्ट करते हैं। पोजी क्लियर करें। थैंक यू पोजी। सो स्टूडेंट, 24th जून इवनिंग शिफ्ट का अगर फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन देखते हैं, इट इज आस्किंग आइडेंटिफाई द पेयर ऑफ फिजिकल क्वांटिटीज दैट हैव सेम डायमेंशन। तो डायरेक्टली अगर आप देखेंगे तो वेलोसिटी ग्रेडियंट और डीके कांस्टेंट दोनों की यूनिट सेम है, डायमेंशंस विल बी सेम। बाकी वीन्स कांस्टेंट की यूनिट है मीटर पर केल्विन, स्टीफन कांस्टेंट की यूनिट वी नो वेल इट इज एनर्जी अपॉन T^4, सो यूनिट्स आर डिफरेंट। एंगुलर फ्रीक्वेंसी इज इन रेडियन पर सेकेंड, सो इट इज पर सेकेंड यूनिट। एंड एंगुलर मोमेंटम इज केजी मीटर स्क्वायर पर सेकेंड, दैट डजंट मैच। ऑप्शन डी, वेव नंबर इज मेजर्ड इन पर मीटर, एवोगाड्रो नंबर इज मेजर्ड इन पर मोल, सो ओनली ऑप्शन ए इज द करेक्ट आंसर वेयर द डायमेंशंस आर मैचिंग। पोजी क्लियर करो। स्टूडेंट्स, इन दिस क्वेश्चन इट इज आस्किंग द डिस्टेंस बिटवीन अर्थ एंड सन इज आर, एंड वी आर रिक्वायर्ड टू कैलकुलेट द ड्यूरेशन ऑफ ईयर इफ द डिस्टेंस बिकम्स 3 आर। सो अगर केपलर स्लॉट डायरेक्टली यूज किया जाए, वी नो स्क्वायर ऑफ टाइम पीरियड इज प्रोपोर्शनल टू डिस्टेंस क्यूब। सो यहाँ पे वी कैन डायरेक्टली राइट T1 अपॉन T2 शुड बी इक्वल्स टू 3R अपॉन R^3/2। सो डायरेक्टली आप ये कह सकते हैं T1, या ये कह सकते हैं T2/T1। सो हियर द वैल्यू ऑफ T2 वी आर गेटिंग इज इक्वल्स टू 3√3 × t, so here it is 3√3 years. So answer to this question will choose as option D directly. Thank you, Boji. इस क्वेश्चन में हमें दिया गया स्टोन ऑफ मास एम इज टाइड टू द स्ट्रिंग व्हिच इज बीइंग व्हर्ल्ड इन अ वर्टिकल सर्किल विद यूनिफॉर्म स्पीड, और हमको स्ट्रिंग टेंशन से रिलेटेड स्टेटमेंट्स को एनालाइज करना है। तो इट्स अ फंडामेंटल थ्योरेटिकल क्वेश्चन कि अगर एक वर्टिकल सर्किल में एक बॉब को वर्ल्ड किया जाता है तो हम अच्छी तरह से जानते हैं टेंशन बॉटम मोस्ट पॉइंट के ऊपर मैक्सिमम होती है, एंड व्हेन इट रीचेस टू द टॉप मोस्ट पॉइंट हियर द वैल्यू ऑफ टेंशन इज मिनिमम, बिकॉज यहाँ पे ग्रेविटी एंड सेंट्रीफ्यूगल फोर्स इन द सर्कुलर फ्रेम ऑफ रेफरेंस आर इंक्रीजिंग टेंशन, एंड वेयर एज एट द टॉप मोस्ट पॉइंट देयर इन अपोजिट मोड। सो हम डायरेक्टली कह सकते हैं टॉप मोस्ट पॉइंट के ऊपर टेंशन इज मिनिमम, तो आप आंसर ऑप्शन यहाँ पे डायरेक्टली बी चूज कर सकते हैं। In this question, it says two identical charged particles, each having mass 10 gram and charge, are placed on a horizontal table with a separation of L between such that they stay in limiting equilibrium. Question is asking if the coefficient of friction between particle and table is 0.25, we are required to find the value of L. So, my dear students, यहाँ पे क्योंकि ये situation limiting equilibrium में है, तो यहाँ पे जो दोनों का charge है plus Q, this will provide a repulsive force. और रिपल्सिव फोर्स एग्जैक्टली यहाँ पे फ्रिक्शन को बैलेंस करेगा, विच इज इक्वल्स टू μmg. सो वी कैन राइट फॉर लिमिटिंग इक्विलिब्रियम वी यूज KQ² / L² इज इक्वल टू μmg. सो डायरेक्टली फॉर्मूले में वैल्यू सब्सटीट्यूट करके यू गेट द रिजल्ट L इज इक्वल्स टू, यू कैन राइट रूट ऑफ KQ² / μmg. So this is giving us the value root of k is 9 × 10⁻⁹ × Q² = 4 × 10⁻⁴ divided by 0.25 multiplied by 10 × 10⁻³ - 3 multiplied by g is also taken as 10. So L ka value aap directly dekh sakte hain yahan pe, this 4 × 4 = 16 multiplied by 9 ka root, this 3 × 4 comes out to be 12 multiplied by this here you can see
there is 10 to power 10, so 10 to power minus 14 is 10 to power minus 2, this is 12 centimeters. So answer option A is the correct option in this question. In this question, it is asking a Carnot engine takes 5000 kilocalorie of heat from a reservoir at 727 degrees centigrade, that's 1000 Kelvin, and it gives heat to a sink at 400 Kelvin. We are required to calculate the work done by engine. So student, directly aap work done ko likh sakte hain. Heat supplied multiplied by 1 minus T2 by T1, that's the efficiency. So aap yahan pe directly value check kar sakte hain. Heat supplied is 5000 kilocalorie multiplied by 1 minus 400 by 1000. So this gives us the value 5000 multiplied by, here it is 600 by 1000, this is 6 by 10, it is 3 by 5. So that comes out to be 3000 kilocalories. So here you can see 3000 kilocalories. If we calculate the values, direct answer, we just multiply with the calorie. So this 3000 multiplied by calorie is 4.2 into 10 to power 3. So this comes out to be approximately matching with answer option C. So here it is in joule. Students, in this question, it says two massless springs with a spring constant 2K and 9K carry 50 and 100 gram masses at the free ends. And they are oscillating vertically such that their maximum velocities are equal, and we are required to calculate their amplitude ratios. So here we know, well, if we talk about the maximum velocity, it is given as A omega. So for the two, we can write A1 omega 1 is equals to A2 omega 2, and the angular frequency of oscillation can be given as root of K by M. So here ratio of amplitudes A1 by A2 can be written as root of omega 2 by omega 1. This is omega 2 by omega 1, which can be written as not root. Here this will be root of omega 2 we can write as K2 by M2 multiplied by omega 1 we can write as M1 by K1. So in this situation, the value we are getting is root of K2 here is 9, M2 here is 100 multiplied by M1 here is 50, and K1 here is 2. So this we are getting as root of 9 by 4, which is 3 by 2. So here answer option B is the correct answer in this question. In this question, it is asking what will be the most suitable combination of three resistances, 2 ohm, 4 ohm, 6 ohm, so that equivalent resistance is 22 by 3. So student, it is just a grade 10 level question. Denominator 3 indicates, humko pata hai ki 4 or 2 ka parallel combination is 8 by 6 is 4 by 3. And 4 by 3 plus 6 directly comes 22 by 3. So directly likh sakte hain, R equivalent is equals to 4 into 2 by 4 plus 2 plus 6. So the 6 in series with 4 and 2 in parallel. So C in series with A and B in combination with the A and B in parallel. So this gives 22 by 3 ohm. So oral question hai, maine phir bhi solve kar diya. So answer option B is the correct answer over here. Thank you, Boji. So student, in this question, it is saying the soft iron is a suitable material for making an electromagnet. This because hum achhi tarah se jante hain, in case of a soft iron is a ferromagnetic material. Aur ferromagnetic material ke liye agar hum baat kare to iska direct indication hai, its mu r is very high. So permeability has to be very high. Aur electromagnet ke liye humko pata hai, for electromagnet these should be quickly energized, means quickly magnetized and quickly demagnetized. So for electromagnets, we must have a retentivity to be very low. Taki retentivity agar low hogi to residual magnetism kam hoga, aur jaise hi current khatam karenge immediately magnet apna magnetism lose kar dega aur soft iron unmagnetized state mein aa jayega. So if retentivity is low and permeability is very high, that is the suitable condition. So answer option will choose here as option C. Thank you, Boji. So this question has been asked multiple times in JEE Main as well as NEET exam. So just have a look quickly. We can solve this question. See, the proton, neutron and an alpha particle with same kinetic energy enters into a uniform magnetic field at right angle. So yahan pe aap directly likh sakte ho. Question mein ratio of radii nikalna hai. So radii of particle we write as mv over qb. So this is the momentum, but yahan pe same kinetic energy ke liye pucha gaya. So we can write root of 2 mk divided by qb. So magnetic field same hai, kinetic energy same hai. So we can write here r is proportional to root m by q. So in this situation, aap dekho, radius of proton is to radius of deuteron is to radius of alpha particle. This will be for proton. If mass is taken as m, this root m divided by charge of proton is e. For deuteron, when we talk about mass, this is root of 2m. Charge of deuteron is still e. And for that of alpha particle, mass is 4m and charge is 2e. So the value you can see we are getting is 1 is to root 2 is to, this is 1 again. So 1 is to root 2 is to 1 means answer option D is the correct answer in this question.
Thank you, Boji. So student, yeah, those statements hame diye gaye hain. Statement 1 says the reactance of an AC circuit is 0. It is possible that circuit contains a capacitor and inductor. So directly keh sakte ho, that's correct. Statement 1 correct hai because agar hamare paas reactance of capacitance equal to reactance of inductance hai, in that case the two in series will nullify each other and Z equal to XC plus XL agar series combination mein phasor lete hain, so this comes out to be 0. So overall reactance or overall impedance can be considered 0 in this situation. But statement 2 aap dekhen, which says in AC circuit average power delivered by source never becomes 0, that's wrong because yahan pe aap ye keh sakte ho, average power is given as Vrms Irms cos phi, where phi is the phase difference between voltage and current. So jab phase angle 90 degree hoga to power factor will be 0, to yahan pe average power 0 ho jayegi, isliye statement 2 is wrong. So here answer option C will choose as the correct answer for this question. Thank you, Boji. Students, this question mein we are given with the potential energy in a potential field given as E by R2 power 10 minus V by R2 power 5. Bohut sare question aise pehle bhi JEE Main mein aa chuke hain. Here R is the interatomic distance. It is saying A and B are positive constants and we are going to calculate the equilibrium distance. So equilibrium ke liye hum force calculate karenge, which is given by minus of du by dr. So if you differentiate, this gives minus 10 A divided by R2 power 11 plus 5b divided by r2 power 6. Yahan pe a b I think yahan pe b capital le lete hain. I think there is a printing error. Now in the situation for equilibrium it should be equal to 0. So aap agar simplify karenge to directly yahan pe r2 power 5 ka value aa jata hai hamare paas 10a by 5b, that gives 2a by b. That means equilibrium position is 2a by b to power 1 by 5, that matches with answer option C. Thank you, Boji. Students, this question mein hame diya gaya, there is an object of mass 5 kg which is thrown vertically up from the ground. Ground se ek boy ne ek object ko upar throw kiya. The air resistance produces a constant retarding force of 10 newton. So agar ye upar ja raha hai, to is body pe downward 10 newton ka force lega. And when it will be coming down, to is pe upward 10 newton force lega, kyunki humko pata hai air resistance motion ke opposite lagta hai. It is asking the ratio of time of ascent to time of descent. So in this situation isme yahan pe plus iska weight lega 5 kg ka, so this 50 newton, so this 60 newton total. Aur iska jo acceleration hoga, this is due to 50 minus 10, so yahan pe 50 minus 10 will be 40 newton. So agar hum yahan pe baat karte hain acceleration during ascent, acceleration during ascent will be 60 divided by 5 is 12 meter per second square. Or acceleration during descent will be 40 by 5, that is 8 meter per second square. And we know that the time of motion hota hai, this is equal to root 2 h by a, or it is inversely proportional to root a. So we directly likh sakte hain, time of ascent divided by time of descent is equal to root of acceleration of descent by acceleration of ascent. So here it is root of 8 by 12, this is root of 2 by 3. That matches with answer option B over here. Directly hum
main to pura solve kiya, aap agar fast calculation karenge dimag mein karenge to itna fair zarurat nahi hote, question to seconds mein solve ho jate.
Thank you, Boji. In this question it says a flywheel is accelerated uniformly from rest and rotates to 5 radian in first second. So hume ye nikalna hai next 2 second mein kitna angle rotate hoga. Again a very fundamental question, because for constant uniform angular acceleration we can write theta is equals to half alpha t square. So in 1 second question mein diya hua, it rotates by 5 radians, so phi is equals to half alpha because t will be taken as 1. Or in 2 second agar apan dekhte hain, to theta
वन अगर वैल्यू निकालें तो दिस हाफ अल्फा मल्टीप्लाइड बाय फोर, दिस कम्स आउट टू बी टू अल्फा. सो इन दिस सिचुएशन अल्फा इज 10, सो दिस कम्स आउट टू बी 20 रेडियन. एंड वी नीड टू कैलकुलेट फ्रॉम टी इक्वल्स टू 1 टू 2 सेकेंड, क्योंकि नेक्स्ट 1 सेकेंड का निकालना है. तो दिस थीटा 2 वी कैन कैलकुलेट कि ओनली इन सेकेंड सेकेंड कितना टर्न हुआ है. तो दिस विल बी 20 माइनस 5 दैट इज इक्वल्स टू 15 रेडियन. सो डायरेक्टली हम आंसर यहाँ पे ऑप्शन बी को चूज करेंगे.
थैंक यू भौजी. In this question, it is saying 100 gram of iron nail is hit by 150 kilogram hammer striking at a velocity of 60 meters per second. It is asking what will be the rise in temperature of the nail if 1/4 of energy goes into heating the nail. So here it is 1/4 of the kinetic energy, which is half mv square, this is for hammer, goes into heating the nail. So we can write it mass of nail multiplied by specific heat multiplied by delta T. So here we are getting the value 1/8 multiplied by 1.5 multiplied by the 60 square is 3600, and that is equals to mass of nail is 100 gram, and here specific heat is 0.42 joule per gram. So I don't need to convert the units. This will be 100 multiplied by 0.42 into delta T. So here the value of delta T I'm getting is, this 100 gets cancelled out and this becomes 9, this is 2, so this is here 1.5, this is 3 multiplied by 9 divided by 4 multiplied by 0.42. when you calculate, the value comes out to be 16.07 degree centigrade, which matches with answer option C in this question. Although calculation here I've written directly because I was aware of, but as far as conceptual clarity is concerned, it hardly takes 60-70 seconds to solve. So conceptual hitting is more important in such questions. In this question, it is saying if the charge on capacitor is increased by 2 coulomb, the energy stored in it increases by 44%. So humko original charge on capacitor nikalna in coulomb. So yahan pe hum directly keh sakte hain, energy stored in capacitor is directly proportional to Q square. So when energy becomes 1.44 times of initial value, so this will be directly written as proportional to 1.2 Q ka whole square. This implies charge increases to 1.2 Q. Jab charge 20% increase hoga, toh hum ye keh sakte hai, energy will be increased by 44%. So in this situation here, we are given that 1.2 Q minus Q is equals to 2. So this gives 0.2 Q is equals to 2, so Q is equals to 10 coulomb. So answer should be directly taken as answer option A. In this question, it says a long cylindrical volume contains a uniformly distributed charge of density rho. The radius of cylindrical volume is r, and the charge particle Q revolves around the cylinder in a circular path. So we need to calculate the kinetic energy. Agar aap yahan dhyan se dekhen, to ek long cylindrical, अगर यूनिफॉर्मली चार्ज सिस्टम है ऑफ रेडियस आर, तो इसके बाहर आर रेडियस पे अगर कोई माइनस क्यू चार्ज होगा ऑब्वियसली, क्योंकि अगर ये पॉजिटिव है तो दिस हैज टू बी माइनस फॉर इट टू बी कॉन्टिन्यूस रिवॉल्यूशन इन अ सर्कुलर पाथ. सो यहाँ पे जो इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड होगा इस सिलेंड्रिकल वॉल्यूम की वजह से, दैट वी कैन राइट एज रो आर स्क्वायर बाय ट्वाइस ऑफ एप्सिलॉन नॉट आर. ये एक्सप्रेशन ऑलरेडी हम पढ़ चुके हैं, एक सिलेंड्रिकल वॉल्यूम के बाहर इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड. सो यहाँ पे जो इलेक्ट्रिक फोर्स इनवर्ड एक्ट करेगा, इसके ऊपर एक्ट करेगा क्यू ई, एंड दैट विल बी बैलेंसिंग और प्रोवाइडिंग द सेंट्रीपिटल फोर्स फॉर द सर्कुलर मोशन. सो यहाँ पे व्हेन यू पुट द वैल्यू, दिस क्यू रो आर स्क्वायर बाय टू एप्सिलॉन नॉट स्मॉल आर इज एम वी स्क्वायर बाय आर. हियर आर गेट्स कैंसिल आउट, सो डायरेक्टली इट गिव्स द काइनेटिक एनर्जी हाफ एम वी स्क्वायर इज इक्वल्स टू क्यू रो आर स्क्वायर बाय फोर एप्सिलॉन नॉट. So if you just match, it is matching with answer option A. That's the correct answer for this question. Thank you, Boji. In this question, we are given that an electric bulb is rated at 200 watt. And question mein pucha ke, what will be the peak magnetic field at 4 meter distance produced by the radiations coming from this bulb? Consider the bulb as a point source with 3.5% efficiency. Ab yahan pe likh sakte hain ki agar ek bulb ki power P watt hai, to at a distance X, यहाँ पे लाइट इंटेंसिटी होगी पी बाई फोर पाई एक्स स्क्वायर, और एनर्जी डेंसिटी आई बाई सी हम लिख सकते हैं बी स्क्वायर बी नॉट स्क्वायर बाई टू म्यू नॉट.
because this will be the maximum intensity which is given by B naught square by 2 mu naught. So when we put the values over here, this gives P, or obviously yahan pe efficiency is 3.5%, so we need to multiply it with eta. So it will be eta P divided by 4 pi x square C is equals to B naught square by 2 mu naught. In question mein magnetic field pucha gaya hai, to B naught ka value aa jayega, it is under the root of this 2 mu naught eta P divided by 4 pi x square C. So numerically when we calculate the root of 2 multiplied by mu naught upon 4 pi is 10 to the power minus 7, eta is 3.5 by 100, power is 200 watts, and x square here will be 16, and c is 3 into 10 to the power 8. I'm just leaving the numerical calculation on you. It will consume hardly 1 or 2 minutes to solve because bahut zyada typical nahi, approximately aata hai 1.7 into 10 to the power minus 8 tesla, which matches here with answer option B. Directly maine calculate kar rakha hai, but here conceptual speed solutions are more important than calculation. Thank you, Boji. So students, here in this question, it says light of two different frequencies with photon energies 3.8 and 1.4 electron volt illuminate a metallic surface, work function given hai. Aur hame nikalna hai ratio maximum speed of emitted electrons. So directly yahan pe likh sakte ho. Kinetic energy in first case will be 3.8 minus 0.6. This will be 3.2 electron volt. Kinetic energy in second case will be 1.4 minus 0.6. This is 0.8 electron volt. For speeds ka ratio nikalna hai, to V1 by V2 you can simply write as root of K1 by K2. That gives root of 3.2 by 0.8. This root 4 is equals to 2. So directly we are getting answer option B. So thoda sa agar aap carefully handle karoge, to within seconds you are able to solve the question. Isme kuch calculation ki zarurat thi nahi. It was an oral question which could be solved and marked answer within 10 to 15 seconds while reading the questions. But brain stimulated hona chahiye aur attacking mode mein hona chahiye. Students, in this question it is saying two light beams are having intensities 9:4 and they are allowed to interfere, and we are required to check the ratio of intensity of maxima and minima. So here in the solution we can write first intensity we can write 9I0, and second intensity we can write 4I0. So in this situation I max by I min if we calculate, so this gives root I1 plus root I2 upon root I1 minus root I2 whole square. That's the contrast ratio. So values humko already pata hai. Yahan pe when you put the values, root 9 is 3, root 4 is 2. This 3 plus 2 upon 3 minus 2 whole square. This is 5 square is 25. So directly we are getting the answer option D over here. Thank you, Boji. Here in this question it says in Bohr atomic model of hydrogen, K, P and E are kinetic potential and total energy of electron. We are required to choose the correct option when the electron undergoes transition to a higher level. So ye already humko as a fact pata hai ki agar lower level se upper level pe ek electron transit karta hai, to iski speed kam ho jati hai. Jitna nucleus se dur honge speed down hogi, to kinetic energy will decrease. Aur jitna hum nucleus se dur hote jayenge, we know well potential energy increase hoti hai. Negative value in, decrease ho rahi hai, but actually it is increasing. So potential energy is increasing. So agar in dono ka sum up dekhenge, to that will also be increasing. So total energy will also be increasing. So aap directly yahan pe choose kar sakte hain. Answer option B is the correct answer. Thank you, Boji. In this question, it says the body is projected from the ground at an angle of 45 degrees. So the base question of projectile motion, agar 45 degree pe koi body project hoti hai, to iski x component or y component velocities barabar hongi. And it is saying its velocity after 2 seconds is 20 meter per second, and the maximum height we are required to calculate. So its horizontal speed, agar u se throw kiya, so this is u by root 2 and this is also u by root 2. This is the uy and this is ux. So we can directly write after 2 seconds, horizontal velocity remains same, vertical velocity becomes uy minus gt. We can write root of u by root 2 whole square, this ux square plus uy square is u by root 2 minus gt, that is g is taken as 10, so 20 whole square. This should be equal to 20, which is already given. So agar square kar dete hain, to u square by 2 plus u square by 2 is u square plus 400 minus this 40 by root 2 into u should be equals to 400. 400 cancel ho gaya, ek u cancel ho gaya. This is giving us the value of initial projection speed to be 40 by root 2 meters per second. So, yahan pe aap directly h max nikal sakte hain, which is u y square by 2g. So, u y is u by root 2. This 40 by 2 is 20. 20 square is 400 upon 20. This comes out to be 20 meter. So, yahan pe this 20 is the answer to this question. Thank you, Boji. Students, here it is saying an antenna is placed in a dielectric medium of constant 6.25. And it is saying the maximum size of that antenna is 5 mm. It can radiate a signal of minimum frequency that we wish to calculate. So, in this question, as antenna size is 5 mm, we can write lambda by 4 is 5 into 10 to power minus 3. That gives the wavelength should be 20 into 10 to power minus 3. And the speed of light, yahan pe nikal sakte hain directly. Speed of light we can write as c upon root of mu r epsilon r, where this becomes 3 into 10 to power 8 divided by root of 6.25, kyunki mu r 1 given hai and root of 6.25 is 2.5, so this 3 upon 2.5 into 10 to power 8 meters per second wavelength hai. So frequency of radiation we can calculate as v by lambda. So here the value is given as 3 into 10 to power 8 divided by 2.5 into 20 into 10 to power minus 3. Numerically, when we calculate this, 33 by 5 into 10 to power 11. So this comes out to be 0.6. The 30 by 5 is 0.66 into 10 to power if I check, I think this 10 to power 10, because yahan pe maine ek zero error liya hai. So here this will be 6 into 10 to power 9 hertz. This comes out to be 6 gigahertz. Gigahertz mein nikalna hai, to here 6 would be the answer to this question. In this question, it says a potentiometer wire of wavelength 10 meter and resistance 20 ohm is connected in series with a 25 volt battery and external resistance 30 ohm. So this is the information given about the primary circuit ki ek 10 meter ki wire hai jiska resistance 30 ohm hai aur isko humne ek battery aur ek external resistance se connect kiya like this. This is a potentiometer wire AV. This is 20 ohm and this is 25 volt. Aur secondary circuit mein ek EMF E ka cell lagaya humne, which is balancing at 250 centimeter of length. This is the jockey. We are required to calculate the value of this EMF. So sabse pehle to yahan pe current nikalein. This 25 by 50, this is 0.5 ampere. Potential difference across AB nikale, the 0.5 ampere is the current flowing through it. So in this case, this 30, this 20, maine yahan pe error kara. This multiplied by 20 is equals to 10 volt. So potential gradient nikale, this is VAB upon L. So this is 1 volt per meter. This is the potential gradient. The potential difference across AJ, which should be equals to the EMF of E, should be equals to lambda multiplied by this balancing length. So here it is 1 multiplied by length is 2.5. This comes out to be 2.5 volt. Value lena hai x by 10 se compare karke. So x yahan pe aata hai 25. That's the answer to this question. In this question, it says two traveling waves of equal amplitude and equal frequencies move in opposite direction along a string. And the interfere to produce a stationary wave whose equation is given by this expression. And we are going to calculate the amplitude of particle at a position. Yahan pe directly aap amplitude ko likh sakte ho 10 cos of pi x, because this is the amplitude of particle and remaining is the oscillating factor. So here this will be 10 cos of, if you put x as 4 by 3, this 4 pi by 3. So 4 cos of 4 pi by 3 is same as cos pi by 3. So this will be 10 multiplied by cos pi by 3 is 1 by 2. This comes out to be 5 centimeter. Directly answer will choose as 5. Students, in this question, it is asking in the given circuit the value of a current through the load resistance. So ek zener diode ke across load laga hua hai, to aapko kuch bhi nahi karna yahan pe. Aap jante hain zener ke across jo voltage hoga VZ, which is equal to 5 volt as it is in breakdown state, kyunki ye 10 volt hai, ये 800 है और ये 1000 है, तो इसके अक्रॉस वोल्टेज 10 की वजह से 5 से ज्यादा होगा, दैट मींस इट इज इन ब्रेकडाउन स्टेट. सो वी कैन डायरेक्टली राइट इन ब्रेकडाउन स्टेट VZ will be maintained at 5 volt. Otherwise, ये open circuit मान लेते हैं और हम accordingly solve कर लेते हैं because it is in reverse bias mode. तो यहाँ पे VZ is 5 volt. So current through the load resistance is 5 divided by 1000, which comes out to be 5 milliampere. So directly answer आपका यहाँ पे आ जाएगा 5. Thank you, Bhuji. Students, in this question, it is given that a sample contains 10 to power minus 2 kilogram each of two substances A and B, and their half-lives are also given. And question mein pucha gaya hai, acha, pehle ye given hai, the ratio of their atomic weights is also 1:2, and the ratio of amounts of A and B after 16 seconds is x/100. So, yahan pe x ki value chahiye, aur x/100 is the ratio of number of atoms, because yahan unit given nahi hai. So, in this situation, aap directly le sakte hain. Pehle to initial atoms yahan pe agar hum dekh lein, तो n नॉट 1 आप लिख सकते हैं मास डिवाइडेड बाय मोलर मास मल्टीप्लाइड बाय अवोगाड्रो नंबर. इसी तरह से n नॉट 2 यू कैन राइट एज m अपॉन मोलर मास 2 इनटू अवोगाड्रो नंबर. एंड बाय डिके इक्वेशन वी कैन राइट n1 बाय n2 इज इक्वल्स टू n नॉट 1 by n naught 2, and numerator we can write this multiplied by 2 to power minus t by half life of 1, and this 2 into minus t by half life of 2. So n naught 1 by n naught 2 aapka ban jayega m2 by m1. So this m2 by m1 multiplied by 2 to power minus time is 16 seconds, this 1 by t1 minus 1 by t2. तो वैल्यू सब्सटीट्यूट करनी है m2 by m1 यहाँ पे डायरेक्ट 2 हो गया, देन दिस 2 टू पावर माइनस 16 मल्टीप्लाइड बाय 1 बाय 4 माइनस 1 बाय 8 इज 1 बाय 8, एंड दिस बिकम्स 2 इनटू 2 टू पावर माइनस 2, दिस 2 बाय 4 इज 1 बाय 2, एंड दिस वी कैन राइट एज x बाय 100. तो दिस गिव्स अस द वैल्यू ऑफ x टू बी इक्वल्स टू 50. दैट्स द आंसर टू दिस क्वेश्चन. थैंक यू पूजी. So student, there's a question of lateral shift by glass slab. I think 10th class se padhte aa rahe ho. It's saying a ray of light is incident at an angle of 60 degree on the glass slab with refractive index root 3. And after refraction, it comes out with a lateral shift. Or lateral shift ka value yahan pe given alka, it is 4 root 3 centimeter. Toh humko thickness of glass slab nikalni hai. Hume already pata hai, the value of L is given as T sine of I minus R by cos R, which we already studied in the fundamental theory. So I given है हमारे पास 60 degree, R we can calculate by Snell's law. So Snell's law से आप directly लिख सकते हो sine 60 degree is equals to mu, which is root 3 sine R. So sine 60 is root 3 by 2, so directly sine R we are getting 1 by 2, means R is 30 degree over here. So if R is equals to 30 degree, तो directly I'll लिख दो 4 root 3, this T. This sine 30 degree divided by cos 30 degree. So this 10 30 is root 3. 10 30 is 1 by root 3. So this 4 root 3 is equals to T into 1 by root 3, which gives T is equals to 12 centimeters. So here 12 is the answer to this question. Thank you, Bhuji. इस क्वेश्चन में हमें दी गई एक सर्कुलर कॉइल विच इज हैविंग 1000 टर्न्स विद एरिया 1 मीटर स्क्वायर एंड इज रोटेटेड अबाउट वर्टिकल डायमीटर एट अ रेट ऑफ 1 रिवॉल्यूशन पर सेकंड इन अ यूनिफॉर्म मैग्नेटिक फील्ड. सो मैक्सिमम वोल्टेज वी आर रिक्वायर टू कैलकुलेट. तो ऑलरेडी हमें रोटेटिंग कॉइल का ईएमएफ पता है. ईएमएफ ऑफ रोटेटिंग कॉइल इन यूनिफॉर्म मैग्नेटिक फील्ड, दिस वी ऑलरेडी स्टडीड इन ईएमआई, एंड दिस गिवन एज और मैक्सिमम वैल्यू कैन बी रिटन एज एन बी ए ओमेगा. अदरवाइज ईएमएफ होता है एन बी ए ओमेगा साइन ओमेगा टी या कॉस ओमेगा टी, डिपेंड की कहाँ से स्टार्ट हुआ है. बट यहाँ हमको सिर्फ वैल्यू चाहिए. तो n इज 1000, b इज 0.07, a इज 1, ओमेगा इज 2 पाई 1, 1 रिवॉल्यूशन पर सेकंड है. सो डायरेक्टली वी आर गेटिंग द वैल्यू एज दिस 140 इनटू पाई इज 22 बाय 7, दिस कम्स आउट टू बी 440 वोल्ट. सो हियर आंसर इज 440. थैंक यू भौजी. Students, here it is given that a monoatomic gas performs a work of Q by 4, where Q is the heat supplied. So it's understood change in internal energy will be 3Q by 4. So molar heat capacity of gas we are required to calculate in this particular process. So yahan pe hum directly likh sakte hain by first law of thermodynamics, Q is equals to delta U plus Q by 4. So this gives delta U is 3Q by 4, which we can write as nCV. For monatomic gas, CV is 3R by 2 multiplied by delta T. And we can write directly Q is equals to nC delta T. Or Q ka value aap yahan se substitute kar sakte ho. The value of Q you can write directly as, you can see the value of Q we are getting is 3 gets cancelled out, 2nR delta T. So we substitute it as 2nR delta T. So this gives us the value of C as 2R. So 2 would be the answer in this question. So 2R would be the molar specific heat of gas in this given process. Thank you, Poji. So students, in this question it says, in the verification of Newton's law of cooling, a graph is plotted between temperature difference with surrounding and time. The initial temperature is taken as 80. We are required to calculate the value of T2 as shown here in the graph. So we can directly write by Newton's law of cooling for this variation in temperature. We write temperature at any point can be given as T initial minus T naught multiplied by e to power minus kt. I hope all of you might have recalled this is delta T. This is the temperature at any time minus temperature difference with the surrounding. So this formula we already derived in theory. So you just need to make use of this relation. So yahan se aap agar dekhenge, 6 minute time pe delta T is 40. So this 40 is equals to, and temperature difference initially it is given as 60 is equals to 60 multiplied e to power minus 6k. And second equation you can write 20 is equals to 60 multiplied e to power minus k into T2, because T2 time pe temperature difference 20. These relations, if you divide, you can see the value we are getting is 40 by 20 is equals to 2 is equals to e to power minus, you can see here we are getting, this is okay, so this k will not get cancelled out over here, this minus k multiplied by 6 minus T2. So this will not be of any output. So what we can do from this relation, we can write ln of 3 by 2 is equals to 6k, and from here we get ln of 3 is equals to k times T2. Now if we divide the relation, this gives T2 by 6 is equals to ln 3. We can also change the base of log 3 divided by log 3 minus log 2, the values which we are already aware, the 0.477 divided by 0.477 minus 0.301. So this gives us the value of T2 is equals to, the values we can see here, T2 is equals to 6 multiplied by 0.477 divided by the 0.176. When you calculate, this comes out to be approximately 16.25 minutes. So here we are required to find the value of T2. So in round figure, we can approximate it as 16 minutes. That will be the answer to this question.